If people ask me what is the best type of whistle, I'm always glad. Because, one, I know that there are different types of whistle. Most think there's only one type of whistle, which is a jack whistle. That's especially here in the mainland Europe, the lower legged variety of whistle. And there's also another type of whistle, which is the parson whistle, which is more longer in the leg and easier able to cover terrain and more speedy, also better wrestler when you introduce the paws. It's not saying that the jack whistle variety is the less of a wrestler. Not by its paws, of course, the jack whistle, but because it's low slung, it tends to get to the bottom of the other dog quite easily, which can also be beneficial to an extent. Both dogs, of course, are no fighting dogs, but all things equal, I would love to have a parson whistle type dog more than a jack whistle type dog. The parson whistle closely resembles the silhouette of a Petterdor Terrier. That's the terrier that I have here on the leash. Gives it more athletic capabilities, more speed. Also, I like a little bit more leggier dog in general. That being said, I've seen very nice jack whistles as well. So don't let the shorter legs scare you off if you can get a good one. Also, the working capabilities of shorter legs dogs can be very good, especially if they are going against mice or rats. The longer legs are not always the benefit, but if you're a little bit close to the ground, you can sometimes be even faster in narrow spaces. Also, the Jack Russell Terrier often has a little bit more pointier snout, whereas the Parson Russell Terrier has more of the snout, as you can see here with my Black Fell Terrier, also known as the Petterdor Terrier, and I like that a lot more. It's a little bit more robust, whereas the snipier snout gives you a little bit more reach. Both have their benefits and drawbacks, of course. But in general, I like this type of head a lot more. Also, it gives you a little bit more of power in the snout, so the bites can be a little bit harder, especially if you have such a small dog. It helps when they have a stronger bite and can get closer to the quarry, for example the fox, to keep it on its throat instead of just working the legs or nose like some other types of snouts are more used to. Besides this, it must be noted that some people say that the Parson Russell Terriers are working terriers, whereas the Jack Russell Terriers are just show terriers. This is not the case. The Parson Russell Terrier is just another show terrier, like the Jack Russell Terrier is now, but both also have working strains. There are not elite working terriers anymore. That's not meaning that you cannot find very good working Jack Russells and working Parson Russell Terriers. They are there. They have a little bit less bravery and silence as compared to the small strong dogs like this Petterdor Terrier, also known as Fell Terriers. Also, the German Jagdterrier has overshadowed the Parson, terrier to quite an extent. But the benefit of the Parson Jack Russell Terriers is that they are quite intelligent in the way of self-preservation. So what this means is that they have a different type of approaching it, often more baying type, and they taunt their quarry more than that they really engage it to go for the ultimate hold. And being the catch dog, they can also take care of it. This is completely different when they engage smaller critters. Eh? For example, with rats or mice or polecats or martens, they often go for the kill. But when they engage a bigger, formidable type of quarry, for example, fox, badger, or hawk, they take this taunting experience to the next level and keep out of harm's way as most as they can, while keeping the pressure up quite a bit. And if this is not sufficient, there's always a way to introduce more bull blood. Mostly miniature bull terriers introduced, but I think that they would benefit more from some small pit bull terrier, or even better, because you're looking for a hunting dog, not a fighting dog, just introduce more of a Patterdale terrier. There are some kennels who do breed Patterdale terrier into their Russell lines, which is a good thing to keep just the working dogs combined. They do this because Patterdale brings a lot of more for bravery and real working elite qualities. The drawback is that often they say there's a different color that they bring. The Jack Russell enthusiasts or Parson Russell enthusiasts want a dog that is dominantly white, whereas the Patterdale brings often the black or red coat. Especially the black is quite dominant. But also in the Patterdale terriers, now and then you see they throw white dogs from the earlier dogs that were used, a throwback. And this throwback can be used to great effect in improving the white fell terrier, but especially the Parson Russell, and eventually also the Jack Russell. As I mentioned before, they have a different type of snout as well. Are you alright? Ik denk het regent ook al. Kom maar. Hoi, hey, rustig, Spikey. Jij ook rustig zijn, hè? Hoi, hoi. Hey. Kom.
Hoepje. Hoepa. Kom maar rustig, hè? Kom maar.
Ja. Kom. Zo, so, you get a little bit of all, I think. Those interbreedings of working breeds, also, for example, those that use Patterdale and Border Terrier blood intertwined, can get very good results. Not only because both breeds have their own certain characteristics, it often also benefits, but also you get heterosis, which means something that we call, for example, in the Dutch language, bastardkraft, which means so much as to be the power of the bastards. It's not that they are not out of a wedding, out of a marriage, but they, because they are different breeds, they often help to create a better one. That new blood is able, because it has similar purposes, to revigorate the other blood. But you also see this in many working strains, also in, for example, pit bull terriers, some very lion bred lines that really perform, or again combined with other lines that also work to bring in fresh blood, let's just say. And the thing is that fresh blood offers exactly that, heterosis. And even two very much line bred individuals of different lines could click and make an enormous improvement. When if you just keep on line breeding and just keeping it very close, you often get very reliable traits, of course, but also inbred problems. They call this, for example, inbreeding depression. So also that they now differentiate the Parson Russell and Jack Russells is not that good of a thing, in my opinion. So what if you want a white dog that's with real working qualities? Where would your best chances be? As I mentioned, I think the Parson Russell from the show dogs has a little bit better starting point and is more used as a hunting dog than the Jack Russell is. But there's another breed that's more of the working breed altogether, which is the white fell terrier. So the Patterdale is an example of a black fell terrier type, but they also have white fell terriers. These are also sometimes named white Lakeland, where the Lakeland is also normally not found in white and is also a show dog, but has been worked and is still being worked by some. Most fell terriers are the black or red type, but sometimes you also have the white fell terrier. And that is often a very good type of worker, kept to work, at your best chance of getting the working type of dog that you want. And if you're just looking for a rat killing monster, a small terrier, almost all terriers will do, but they're also breed specifically bred for that purpose and kept as such in different places in the world. In the Netherlands we call it the Boer fox. In the United States of America they have the red terrier. There's also the plumber terrier, which could be seen as a variety of Russell terrier, with introductions of a little bit of beagle and to say some bull blood, to say bull terrier, but I think more American pit bull terrier or Staffordshire bull terrier is introduced because of the air set. Those could be good options as well, specifically developed for ratting, but also plumber terrier has a very limited genetic base and is now being revigorated by especially adding Patterdale blood, so Patterdale could be at least as good as an option. And there's of course the Spanish variety, which is the Bodegrero. It is bred to exterminate especially rats in the vineyards, the wine cellars. So I hope this helps. Have a nice day.